Question 19, we're dealing with domains and ranges of functions. So one of the best tools in doing this is to kind of reconstruct the graph. So if you've got a graphing calculator, that would be a very helpful thing to have to actually do a graph of these. Notice Alex does not give us the graphing calculator. I don't think it ever does for some reason. I haven't seen it yet. So that's why if you're going to use graphing, you will need that. You could do it with decimals. So let's look at this. Let's start with the sine. I think the sine is the easiest one to explain and maybe the easiest one to draw. So a sine function. And we have this graph. Sine starts at 0, and then it goes up, and at pi over 2, it becomes 1, and then at pi, it becomes 0 again, so it comes down like that, and then at 3 pi over 2, it goes down to 1, and then at 2 pi, so this is one wave of the sine function. And it just keeps on going and going in both directions. So what we see is there is no undefined values for x. X can be anything. Any x that we plug into this, we will get a y value. And so we will say the domain for the sine function is a set of all real numbers. What about the range? Well, you can see that sine function itself, it has the highest value it has is positive 1. And down here, the lowest value is negative 1. That comes from the unit circle. And again, where is my unit circle? I think I opened up. Here we go. Trig exam formulas. I do have it open here. So, the highest sine ever goes is positive 1, the lowest it goes is negative 1. Okay, so using your unit circle, we create that. So the range is going to go the set of all real numbers from negative 1 to 1, the set of all real numbers less than or equal to negative 1 and greater, it's between negative 1 and 1. So that's sine. Now for secant and tangent, these are both ratio functions. I guess we talked about tangent first, and you're going to see that once we do that, we will also easily come up with the secant. So tangent x. Tangent is sine x over cosine x. So tangent's domain is going to have a problem whenever cosine x is equal to 0. We're going to have to take those out. So when is cosine x equal to 0? From the unit circle, we see that that happens whenever, so cosine sort of starts up here at 1 and then goes down the opposite of sine. It's at pi over 2. Pi over 2, cosine is equal to 0. At pi, it's negative 1. And then at 3 pi over 2, it's equal to 0 again. And then we go up to 1. So this is one wave of the cosine function. So we have zeros here and here. So that's every time pi over 2. And what you'll see is it's the odd values. Because pi itself, remember, we can think of this as 2 pi over 2. That's also pi, so that's an even. So it's the odd powers, odd multiples of pi over 2. The set of all real numbers except these odd integer multiples of pi over 2. Okay, so that's what the domain is. We have to take these places where cosine equals 0. We have to take it out. And then what does a tangent look like? Because it's a sine over cosine, what you see is, okay, these two, I guess if, as we were going, these are like asymptotes. When cosine is negative one, sine is zero. So we, that, and that's okay. You can have zero in the numerator. But when it ends up happening, and I can't remember if it goes this way or goes the other way, but you get a curve with tangent. Actually, I do remember. It kind of comes up like this, the tangent function. And again, if you graph it, you'll see that. And so what you see is that the range is all real numbers for tangent. It's everything. Okay, we do get that. It's just the domain is limited. So for tangent, the range is going to be the set of all real numbers. Okay, so that's that. Finally, secant. Secant, you have to look up, is going to be 1 over cosine of x theta. Okay, so it's going to have the same domain as tangent because the problem occurs whenever the denominator becomes 0. So again, the same question, when is cosine x equal to 0? That has to be taken out of the domain. And so we have the same issue with odd powers, odd multiples of pi over 2, 90 degrees. So the domain, we do the same thing, set of all real numbers except the odd multiples of pi over 2. Now, if it was secant, those would occur every 0, at every 0 or pi, or multiples of pi, all multiples of pi. So I guess if you got that one, that's it. But what about the range? So, because there is no sine here, it's a reciprocal cosine function. So what ends up happening, let's go ahead and just use gold here. I'll build off of this cosine graph here, and the tangent will, maybe I'll try to erase that to erase the tangent part there. Just make it disappear. So secant is going to be a reciprocal. So as this gets smaller, the secant actually is going to get larger. So hopefully you'll remember it'll kind of go like this. And right here, the reciprocal of negative one is still negative one. And then it goes like that. On the other side, where this goes to one, you're going to see secant goes like this. So it's a bunch of U-shaped up and U-shaped down things. But you get no values where there's the cosine, because right, those are all reciprocal values, and anything smaller than one is reciprocaled up here. So you get everything for as far as the range is concerned, except it, you don't, you are, the range is less than or equal to negative one, or it's greater than or equal to positive one. So up here for our range, this is the one we said, set of all real numbers less than or equal to negative one or greater than or equal to one. So that's secant. And it really comes from looking at the graphs. Okay, that's 19.